Studies are almost always about the effects of diseases on populations, but people would generally like to know what it means for them as individuals. Here's a quick guide to communicating in a way that's more relevant to people making their own decisions. In August 2019, there was a flurry of worrying headlines about the link between hormone replacement therapy, or HRT, and an increased risk of breast cancer. The Telegraph said, "Women on HRT urged to review treatment with their GP following new breast cancer risk evidence." The Sun, "Pause it. HRT treatment for menopause increases risk of breast cancer by a third, experts warn." The Guardian, "Breast cancer risk from using HRT is twice what was thought." These headlines were based on a good quality paper in The Lancet, which summarized recent evidence on the links between HRT and breast cancer. One of the strongest statements in the paper was, "If the associations are largely causal, hormone therapy use in Western countries has already caused about 1 million breast cancers out of a total of 20 million since 1990. This can sound very worrying, but what does it mean to an individual? These apparently dramatic effects on populations are, of course, very important when it comes to making policy recommendations about HRT, but strictly speaking are not so relevant when it comes to an individual making her own decision about her treatment. What she would like to know is what would be her risks if she doesn't take HRT of getting breast cancer, compared with her risks if she did take HRT. And here's a good way of communicating this. The Lancet were extremely good at providing the following information. And this represents 50 women of average weight in developed countries, aged 50 and not taking HRT. And out of these, we'd expect 3 to develop breast cancer over the next 20 years. That's before they're 70. So let's compare that with 50 similar women, aged 50, average weight, developed countries, but now taking HRT for 5 years. We'd expect 3 to develop breast cancer, just as in the other group, but also 1 extra linked to the HRT. Now, you see, that is a 1/3 increase in risk, which we saw in the Guardian headline earlier, but that was a relative risk. And these difference in absolute risks tells the story much more clearly. Now, of course, if a woman were getting substantial benefits in her quality of life from the HRT, she may feel that this extra risk, as 1 extra case out of 50 taking HRT for 5 years, was small enough to be acceptable. Now, of course, that's her choice, but this form of communication may help inform her decision. So, if you want to communicate in a way that's most relevant to individuals, then we would recommend using the ideas of absolute risks, perhaps in this format. If we're talking about policy recommendations, then it's the effects on populations that are relevant, such as the 1 million extra cases we heard about earlier. The appropriate way of reporting depends on who is making what decision about whom.